Hello students, so we begin our discussion on aphorism number 172, which starts with the discussion on one-sided diseases. What are one-sided diseases? They are the diseases with too few symptoms. So patient presents with one or two principal symptoms. So one-sided diseases are diseases with few symptoms, and that's a difficult situation again for the physician, and they are difficult to treat because of presence of too few symptoms. And why they are difficult to treat? Because the symptoms are only the pointers for selection of remedy. So, owing to the too few symptoms present in the patient, the selection of simillimum becomes difficult. So, let's see what are the instructions given by Dr. Hahnemann in such difficult situation. So here again the discussion is further done on one-sided diseases, which are nothing but diseases with too few symptoms. So one-sided diseases are chronic diseases with few symptoms. So there will be one or two prominent symptoms. Chronic diseases are caused by fundamental cause, and fundamental cause is nothing but miasms. So all of you keep in mind, one-sided diseases are chronic diseases with few symptoms. So they are miasmatic in origin. So patient presents with one or two symptoms. So we go further. So let's see how to handle this difficult situation step by step. So the principal symptoms may be only headache or diarrhea. Such symptoms are called as the internal complaints. So patient presents with one or two symptoms, like say only headache or only diarrhea, and they are surely the internal complaints of the patient. Now let's see this is the first variety. Let's see the second variety. But if the symptoms are external, seen only on skin, they are called as local maladies or local diseases. So these principal symptoms, one or two, trivial in nature, chronic in nature, caused by miasms, they are of type internal and external. So the internal sufferings of the patient in the form of headache or diarrhea, they are internal complaints. Similarly, some patients present with only external symptoms, that too few symptoms seen on skin. They are labeled as local maladies or local diseases. They are labeled as local maladies or local diseases. Symptoms felt by the patient are internal symptoms, and those symptoms which are seen externally are external symptoms. They are not due to external cause. So these symptoms which are seen externally are not due to any external cause. They are not due to any external injury. They are not due to any external contact. So the symptoms which are seen externally are the external symptoms. Symptoms felt by the patient are internal symptoms. And those symptoms which are external on skin but not arising due to external cause such as injury or any contact, they are termed as local maladies or local diseases. So subsequent aphorisms, Dr. Henneman gives a detailed instructions to the physician how to treat these local maladies or local diseases. So here in this aphorism, Dr. Henneman gives us the idea that one-sided diseases are of two varieties, internal and external. But the external, be sure that the external symptom seen on the skin is not due to any external cause. So no external injury, no external contact with any surface. Their mere presence on the surface of the body, but surely they are not due to external cause. So say for example, warts which are present, say for example, corns present, acne, eczema are the symptoms which are seen externally on the surface or on the skin, and they are surely not caused by any external cause. They are one-sided diseases with too few symptoms of disease. So let's be sure that if patient is suffering from one or two trivial symptoms such as headache or diarrhea, you may label it as one-sided diseases. And what are one-sided diseases? They are diseases with too few symptoms. They are chronic in nature, so miasmatic in origin. They never arise due to any external cause. The principal symptoms, one or two, may be internal complaints or external complaints. Internal complaints, for example, headache, diarrhea, and externally, such as, for example, say warts, corns, eczema, acne, seen externally, but surely not arising due to any external injury. They are termed as local maladies. Okay, so I have repeated this concept. So we go further. In aphorism number 175, so one-sided diseases are with few symptoms. So at first kind, it seems one-sided diseases are due to lack of discernment of physician to judge the symptoms and construct the portrait of disease. What is that? Discernment means what? The ability to judge something well, or the ability to understand and comprehend something. So at first it is like that, maybe due to physician's lack of discernment, means ability to judge. So physician is not able to judge the other symptoms and is able to perceive only one or two symptoms, and then there is a deficiency in constructing the portrait of disease. But it is not the case here. So really, one-sided diseases are diseases with few symptoms. It is not due to the physician's lack of observation or lack of judgment or lack of understanding or comprehension of patient's narration of his symptoms. They are really diseases with few symptoms. Okay, so we go further. Aphorism number 176. So, you know, each aphorism, few points are mentioned step by step, and then we are arriving at how to manage these one-sided diseases. So, one-sided disease is nothing but with too few symptoms of disease. So, after careful observations, during case taking, physician observes that there are few cases with only few symptoms. Only one or two symptoms may be of violent nature and others are of vague nature. So, only one or two symptoms are prominent symptoms or principal symptoms or characteristic symptoms which are prominently seen by the patient and narrated and observed by the physician, and other symptoms are vague in nature. They are very common in nature. Now see further, aphorism 177. So, one-sided diseases with too few symptoms of disease. The discussion is further that although such cases are rare with few symptoms, selection of simulimum is based on these few symptoms only. So, selection of simulimum has to be done on these few prominent characteristics symptoms, may be of violent intense nature. So, aphorism number 177 just telling us that this phenomena of one-sided diseases seen in patients, which means diseases with too few symptoms, are although rare, not very common. They are the diseases with few symptoms, but selection of simulimum has to be based on these few symptoms. Now, let's see what difficulties further arise for the physician and what are the guidelines laid by Dr. Hahnemann to solve such difficult cases. So, here in aphorism number 178, that reference to the 176th aphorism, see this, that one or two symptoms may be of violent nature or they are of prominent nature or characteristic nature, and see further. These symptoms are called as peculiar, striking, uncommon, characteristic symptoms, and selection of remedy is on strict homeopathic principles, that is under the law of similars. This remedy has potential to produce similar artificial disease. So, when we are administering the simulimum which corresponds to these few symptoms, then this remedy has already has potential to produce similar artificial disease. Means what? This remedy in its pathogenesis during drug proving has already produced such similar symptoms in the prover. And hence we can quote that this remedy has potential to produce similar artificial disease. To remove the morbid symptoms of natural disease. So, artificial disease is produced which removes the morbid symptoms of natural disease. This is called as cure. So, let's revise again that diseases with few symptoms when they are peculiar, striking, uncommon, characteristic in nature, then the selection of remedy is easy and is strictly done under the law of similars, which is a homeopathic principle. This remedy has already produced such symptoms during drug proving. Thus, its pathogenesis is already noted in homeopathic materia medica, and this remedy is capable of removing the morbid symptoms of natural disease, and physician can achieve cure. All of you are well aware that remedy can remove the symptoms in the patient only if it has produced similar symptoms during drug proving. Thus, disease curing power lies in the disease producing power. So, the point is noted that even though the few symptoms are there, and if it corresponds to the remedy which has in its proving and pathogenesis generated such symptoms in prover listed in homeopathic materia medica, then it surely cures by removing the morbid symptoms of natural disease, and the artificial disease is produced by it in the patient, takes hold of the patient, and he no longer experiences the morbid symptoms of natural disease, and he is pathway of cure which is achieved soon. So we go further. Aphorism number 179, that one-sided diseases are nothing but too few symptoms of disease. So it is very often that the medicine chosen in such cases may be partially similar. The number of symptoms are short, because short means too few. So to arrive at accurate prescription, what should be done? So I again revise here that suppose a medicine in its pathogenesis has reported the symptoms say A to Z in the prover, and it is listed in homeopathic materia medica. And now when the patient comes with only one or two symptoms, very few symptoms, say A, B, C, D, then that remedy can be chosen and can be prescribed. And this is the, although number of symptoms are short, this remedy is prescribed, and this is called as partially similar remedy to arrive at accurate prescription. So we go further. In such cases, the remedy is unhomeopathic, because it is partially similar and only some symptoms are cured. So, as we have seen in aphorism 162, where we have seen the discussion where limited number of remedies are available. In such cases also, imperfect remedy is given and it produces accessory symptoms. So what are accessory symptoms? If you remember, they are the symptoms of this unhomeopathic remedy. So new symptoms are produced by this unhomeopathic remedy. These symptoms get mixed with the symptoms of patient. So here what happens in the cases when there are too few symptoms? So remedy selection is difficult. So in such cases, yet we have to prescribe a remedy, and that is unhomeopathic, means it is not covering the all the these of all the few symptoms. It is only covering the one or two symptoms out of say three or four. So again the same phenomena takes place. The new symptoms arise because of this unhomeopathic remedy, and patient may have experienced in the past some symptoms which were vague may become pronounced. So what does that say? That due to the administration of this unhomeopathic remedy, which is called as partially similar remedy, some symptoms of the patient may get cured and some new symptoms may arise, or some symptoms when patient has experienced in the past, they become more pronounced. So all these three types of condition may arise after the prescription of this unhomeopathic remedy. So either the few symptoms are cured, or some symptoms which patient had experienced in the past get more pronounced. So this either of these phenomena may take place. So we go to the next aphorism. So 181st aphorism, one-sided disease with too few symptoms of disease. The new symptoms which arise in the patient are due to the medicine administered. And what is the name of this medicine? Is nothing but it is partially similar medicine. Hence, it is able to remove few symptoms and few new symptoms may arise. The whole collection of symptoms is now considered as due to the disease itself. So now what we do? We take the remaining symptoms of patient plus say any new symptoms added because of the medicine administered, and we construct the totality further for selection of the different remedy. So we continue further. This imperfect selection of medicine was inevitable, means it was justified as the patient presented with only few symptoms. Hence, the remedy choice was difficult. So this medicine now completes the totality as it produces few unhomeopathic symptoms. Thus, the imperfect selection of medicine facilitates selection of second more accurate suitable medicine. So again, this type of journey is continuous, where because of too few symptoms, we are administering a remedy which will cure amongst these few symptoms, one or two symptoms, and will produce new symptoms as it is not a similimum but partially similar. So it may produce few new symptoms. Now physician has to construct the totality again, where the patient's remaining symptoms plus new symptoms of this unhomeopathic remedy, and again this facilitates selection of second more accurate suitable medicine. So the journey continues. Again, the physician has to select second more accurate and suitable medicine, as now the symptoms, number of symptoms have increased, means patient symptoms plus few new symptoms which are produced due to the administration of these unhomeopathic remedy. So we continue further. Aphorism number 183. So when the first dose of the medicine ceases to have beneficial effect, then a new examination of totality is formed of morbid state. So when we understand that when we have given the first dose of this unhomeopathic remedy and now it has done its best, it has done the beneficial effect is achieved. So means what? The one or two symptoms of the patient have disappeared. And now what is the job of physician? A new examination of totality is to be done. That means what are the symptoms of patient which are remaining? And if at all any new symptoms are produced due to the remedy of previously administered. So now the totality is formed. The selection of second suitable remedy is done. Now the selection, we hope that it is a more appropriate remedy. And the symptoms constituting the totality are naturally now more in number. They have increased. How they have increased? Because the previous remedy has removed few symptoms and has also produced few new symptoms. So one or two symptoms of patient are cured, they are, it disappears, and one or two new symptoms of the remedy are produced, and the totality is constructed again for the selection of more appropriate remedy. This is helping the physician to complete the totality. So footnote is saying that it is rare in chronic disease but seen in acute disease that patient feels very ill but has few symptoms or indistinct symptoms due to the benumbed state of nerves. It can be treated by opium. It is patient's internal sensibility, and in its secondary actions, symptoms are distinctly present. So, it is rare in chronic disease but seen in acute disease that patient is very ill and there are very indistinct symptoms due to the benumbed state of nerves. So, in such cases, you can treat him by opium. It is patient's internal sensibility and its secondary action symptoms are distinctly present. So, in such cases where patient is very ill but is giving only few symptoms, it is due to the benumbed state of nerves. So, you can administer opium in such cases. So that's the example given by Dr. Hahnemann. We go to the last aphorism in today's discussion, that each new dose of medicine has now exhausted its action and its suitableness. The state of disease now which remains is to be examined new. New suitable medicine is searched and it completes the cure. So by doing this, we are able to reach to cure. So this process will be continued till the physician achieves cure. So this was a discussion on selection of remedy. First we call it as an imperfect remedy in cases of one-sided diseases. Okay, so next presentation will be on treatment and management of local diseases. So we stop here now. Okay. Thank you.